Hello, I'm Eleanor Schano White. You know, if there's one thing I've learned in the 25 years I've spent in the news business, it's that news is people. Famous people and those not so famous. Successful people and even those who have failed. The comic, the tragic, the inspiring. People trying to excel or just trying to keep even. That's the perspective of everyone here at Channel 12, and it's one that I'm personally and professionally committed to. It's also one more reason why now, more than ever, Channel 12 is your station for news.
This is Channel 12 News, the 6 o'clock report with Eleanor Schano White.
Good evening, everyone. Firefighters are back on the scene tonight in Loxahatchee. That major brush fire, which was contained last night, broke out again today. And we have a series of reports, beginning with Patty Oates, who is flying over the area at this moment in Sky 12. Patty, what's the situation out there?
Eleanor, the fire has pretty much burned itself out, but several spot fires continue to burn here, and firefighters are mopping them up. Officials believe today's fire was rekindled from yesterday's fire. It broke out in roughly the same area of Loxahatchee shortly before noon today, between E and F roads, north of North Road in the northern part of Loxahatchee.
Okay, John and Patty, thanks for those live reports. You know, one of the big problems contributing to these fires is the weather. Patty Sherman is here with us now to tell us if the dry and windy conditions which have been plaguing our area will continue. Patty, do we have any rain in the forecast?
We have a little bit of rain, but it is the lack of rain that's the main problem. We had a few coastal showers today, but that brings only temporary relief.
An inmate on Florida's death row is one step closer to the electric chair tonight. Governor Bob Graham signed a death warrant for triple murderer Gary Elden Alvord. Alvord was convicted of strangling three Tampa residents during a robbery in 1973. He's scheduled to die on May 1st. Appeals on behalf of Alvord are likely. Well, an investigation is underway tonight into possible criminal charges in that condo collapse in Cocoa Beach. Five workers were killed, 23 injured late last month when the partially finished building collapsed. The Cocoa Beach police chief says tonight, if enough evidence is uncovered, he'll file manslaughter charges against anyone found responsible in the tragedy. Palm Beach County mass transit may soon become more expensive and provide less service. Stan Zimmerman reports the system is reacting to federal cutbacks and massive deficits. There are a few new faces elected to the Riviera Beach City Council. With the recent election, as Laurel Sauer reports, it could change the shape of future issues in the city. Everything's right on schedule tonight at Cape Canaveral in preparation for Friday's shuttle launch. When we return, Stephanie Stahl has a special report with a former astronaut who knows the feeling of blasting off. Astronauts Robert Crippen and John Young have arrived at Cape Canaveral. All systems are go for Friday's launch. A large group of prominent people from our area will be traveling with former astronaut Ed Mitchell to watch the historic event. Stephanie Stahl has a report.
Ed Mitchell traveled to the moon aboard Apollo 14.
In spite of the current tense situation in Poland, members of the West Palm Beach Polish American Club turned out in native costume to participate in the first in a series of cultural events on campus. It was a bittersweet occasion today since, for the most part, the singing and dancing was masking the deep concerns these folks have for friends and family back home. We shared a tearful moment with one woman distraught over the welfare of her parents, brothers, and sisters.
Relatives, to my parents, for all people in Poland.
You agreed to do this interview with us and to talk about your family in Poland, but you said you didn't want your name used and you didn't want to be seen on television. What are you afraid of?
Well, I'm afraid because if I go to Poland, you're gonna interview me, I think.
And you're afraid they wouldn't let you come back?
Of course, of course.
Mrs. Sobieczynski, is there real justification for the fear of the lady we just talked about?
Absolutely, there is justification. We hear it from all sides. We get it in the mail. Friends of ours get it in the mail, and there certainly is justification. Oh, yes.
We're hearing reports that the economic conditions are so bad that some people are not getting enough food.
That is true. That is absolutely true.
These people admit it's difficult to sing and dance knowing friends and relatives face possible Soviet intervention, but it's their hope that today's event will focus attention on the spirit and the courage of the Polish people. No doubt about it. No doubt about it, Palm Beach is easy to take, especially in the springtime and especially on Worth Avenue, one of the most famous shopping streets in the whole world. Well, today, 12 News photographer Phil Zeroni joined me for a very special visit, and we invite you to come along. According to Roman legend, Flora is the goddess of flowers, and the Esplanade here on Worth Avenue has entered into the true spirit of the season with its Floralia celebration. Here, all 40 shop owners have competed for the most beautiful, most unusual, and most whimsical use of fresh flowers. There are thousands of beautiful blooms and buds everywhere. Visitors entering the Esplanade through valet parking are greeted with a rainbow of colorful Gerber daisies. And it's one charming window display after another. Two great purple turtles made out of over 1,000 pom-poms and daisies. Elsewhere throughout the courtyard, hanging baskets are just dripping with blossoms. Even a peacock of flowers in a men's store window, the tail of which is a display of colorful neckties. All in all, it's a flower lover's dream come true. And it's our tribute to you tonight as we celebrate the first full week of spring. That's the early edition of 12 News. ABC World News is up next. For Jim and Patty, the entire 12 News team, I'm Eleanor Schano White. Thanks for joining us, and have a good weekend, everyone.
Excellent. try.
Yeah, I'll take it.
Yeah,
stay.
Bring that groundwork.